Tell us sort of what you guys are doing and how you're addressing the marketplace.
Sure. We make an app called NextGuide. Basically, NextGuide is your next generation TV guide. It lets you search across live TV combined with Hulu, Netflix, Amazon, and iTunes all in one view, set alerts, set reminders, bookmark stuff, find out what your friends are watching through Facebook. It's basically kind of TV guide reinvented for the modern era. Dijitâ is a small company. We're less than 10 people. We're funded by Silicon Valley venture capitalists, including Alsop Louis Partners, who were, by the way, the first investors in TiVo back in the day. Our team has a lot of TV industry experience, including Sling Media, companies like Boxy, Clicker, Vudu, and others.
There's been a lot of companies that have sort of, you know, created these kinds of apps, I guess. I mean, what are you guys doing that's different, and where do you think the traction is going to come?
So NextGuide is actually the first app that lets someone search across live TV listings combined with streaming sources all at the same time. So that's the first thing that's getting people really excited. Also, we've done social implementation in a really smart way. Basically, we import all of your Facebook friends. If you do a Facebook Connect, we import all of the likes that your friends have done. And so in our app, you get one quick view that shows you, you know, you ever wonder, oh, my buddy always tells me to watch that movie and I never remember what I want. It's all there presented for you automatically. It works really easily, and people are loving it so far.
Tell us about the business and about, you know, who's using it and who pays for it, at least on the, you know, and what your business model is.
So we launched a couple of months ago, and we're growing steadily every month. Our business model, we actually work very similar to how the TV industry works. Basically, it's data mining combined with what's called tune-in advertising. Basically, it's a place where TV producers can show previews of their shows that are upcoming to try to get a new audience to tune into them. So right now, we're not making any revenue, but that's something on the tracks for 2013.
So how do you index all that? You must have gigantic spiders, or how does it, you know, how do you index all that content?
Well, we work with a few third-party companies. So we work with Tribune Media Services for metadata, Internet Video Archive for movie trailers, and a bunch of other providers as well to figure out where everything is. On top of that, we built our own interest graph, and that's basically, it's our own dictionary, if you will, of terms relative to TV. Things like hockey or San Francisco or New York or actors or actresses, and that's an important part of it.
So what do you think the use case is going to be? How will it develop? What do you think the appeal will be for consumers?
Well, I think we're entering an interesting era of TV watching. You know, in the past, it was all live. Everything was live. You had no choice. And then we went from live to live with time shifting. And then we introduced live, where we are now, live and time shifting and streaming and on demand. All of those are kind of combined. We think the future is going to be much more about on demand and streaming, with live as kind of a service add-on for sports and reality and other types of things. So we think being able to find out where content is going to be one of the biggest challenges for consumers in the future.
What's next for the industry? You know, how do you see things developing, and, you know, in terms of this whole convergence and, you know, kind of the things are happening quickly. Where are things shaking out?
I think, you know, as they say, the more things change, the more they stay the same. I think when we look at what's happening and changing in TV, I think it's a lot more under the hood. So some of the rights are changing. Some of the who makes deals with who and how and for how much and for how long are changing. The mechanisms are changing. Instead of it being broadcast, it might be streamed. But I think fundamentally TV as a medium is actually going to look a lot the same a few years from now as it does today.